the government announced that the 21st September birthday of Kwame Nkrumah would be honored as a birthday. That's a change after initially just stating that it's going to be commemorative. And coming off the background that August 4th has been set aside as a collective Founders Day, how would you react to that?
Well, I'm not sure how I'm supposed to react to this, but at least the understanding that the day will be recognized as Kwame Nkrumah's Day and declared a public holiday, it's a welcome capitulation of what initially had been an attempt at revising history. And I think facts are facts and they're pretty sacred. I mean, why would you want to... We can understand why people want to put a shine on things, politics, whatever, but it's a welcome capitulation that Kwame Nkrumah's Day is being set aside for people to commemorate and actually celebrate his contribution to this nation.
So you say it's the attempt to alter facts, historical facts. It's a serious issue. Now, taking into consideration that majority of the population are the youth, how should the youth relate to this whole issue of the Founders Day?
Eventually, truth, facts reign. So for a moment, you can fool people, but eventually the facts will prevail. So even if it's rewritten, there'll be a time when the right facts will prevail. So fortunately, people are researching, people are reading, people are publishing. It's just a matter of time. And canon of Ghanaian history will be made available. So eventually facts grow.
Okay, so Nana, you are an author and a specialist in anthology. So currently in Ghana, there are a lot of publications on this issue. Or should I say, there aren't enough publications on this issue, which makes it kind of dicey that a government can come at any point in time and determine that, okay, so this isn't the history, we want to go the other way. What role do writers, publishers and anthologists have to play in ensuring that the historical facts are preserved?
Good question, but the role is actually for the citizen, the good citizen. The role is to defend the facts as have been put down. Initially, the idea of the independence of Ghana has been a fact that has been there for the past 50 how many years, and it's been endorsed by historians, it's been celebrated by politicians of all sides. It's been sung about, written about by various Ghanaian literati. And it's only recently that the revisionist approach has been taken towards changing it. And it's obviously political. And you know, the Ghanaian tradition of PP and CPP, it's obviously rubbish for them to change anything, but the attempt was made. So the role of the writer is the same role that the good citizen must have, is to always speak against falsehoods whenever they spring up, no matter from what quarters they come. It's always to preserve and promote facts as sacred so that we can have our opinions about how things happened. But the fact that they happened, we should not fight about. And politics has absolutely no way and no space in deciding what history is all about.
Nana, would this conversation ever go away?
Oh, of course, yes, yes. I mean, eventually, the fact that Kwame Nkrumah was the first president, I mean, there's no... That makes him the founder. And the founder has been celebrated. So that conversation has gone away. It was just recently resurrected for some reason, I'm not sure. But it will definitely go away after the next Republic.
All right, so 21st September is here again with us. What would be your last words on this issue?
Let, read some books, anything about what Kwame Nkrumah wrote or what people have written about Nkrumah. Or just ask some older people about Kwame Nkrumah. I mean, it would be a nice way of celebrating greatness. Because it looks like for a long time, we've been idolizing mediocrity. And since the mid-70s, Ghana's development has been aborted. So until recently, when this recent republic started, we were really lost in the wilderness. Now just read, listen, talk to somebody about how we got here. And you know, it makes things clearer and it makes us a bit more patriotic. We can celebrate Kwame Nkrumah by learning about our history.
All right, Nana, thank you very much. Prime News Ghana is grateful for your time.
Thank you. That's what I mean.